The Raspberry Pi Pico 2 doesn't just promise more power. It brings 4 cores to the table with 2 ARM and 2 RISC-V cores. But how does it compare to the ESP32-S3, a board that runs at 240 MHz and includes a dual-core processor with a hardware FPU? I ran the same benchmark on both boards, same code, same screen, same power supply. The results were surprising, and they reveal a lot about how these two chips really perform. Before we run the computation speed benchmark I have set up, let's quickly review the basic specs so you know what to expect. The Raspberry Pi Pico 2 features a total of 4 cores, 2 ARM Cortex M33 cores and 2 RISC-V cores. Only one pair of cores is active at a time, either the ARM Cortex M33 cores or the RISC-V cores. And in this video, we will be testing both to see how each one handles the exact same workload. By default, the Pico 2 runs at 150 MHz in the Arduino environment. It comes with 512 KB of SRAM, 4 MB of flash, and includes a hardware floating point unit, something the original Pico lacked. If you haven't seen it yet, check out my previous video where I compare the Pico 2 to the original Raspberry Pi Pico in the same benchmark. The results were pretty surprising. The ESP32-S3, on the other hand, is powered by two 32-bit Extensa LX7 cores, clocked at 240 MHz. It also features 512 KB of SRAM, typically 8 MB of external PSRAM, and includes a hardware FPU as well. The S3 is known for its support for Wi-Fi, Bluetooth Low Energy, and vector instruction, though none of these features are used in this benchmark. Based on clock speed alone, you might expect the ESP32-S3 to easily outperform the Pico 2. But as we have seen before, clock speed doesn't tell the whole story. Different architectures handle the same code in different ways, and that's exactly what this test is designed to reveal. To make this a fair and meaningful comparison, I have prepared an identical setup for both boards. Each one will run the exact same Arduino sketch to calculate the value of Pi using 100,000 iterations of a simple approximation algorithm. The code is written to run on a single core only, to better reflect how most makers actually use their boards. Few Arduino projects take advantage of multi-core programming. The result of each calculation will be shown on a 1.8-inch SPI color TFT screen. Both boards are powered on at the same time from the same USB power bank. As you can see, the ESP32-S3 completed the task in about 4.7 seconds, while the Raspberry Pi Pico 2 needed just 3.6 seconds. That means the Pico 2 was actually around 23% faster than the ESP32-S3 in this benchmark, despite running at a lower clock speed. And honestly, that result was unexpected. The ESP32-S3 runs at 240 MHz, while the Pico 2 in this test was running at just 150 MHz. On paper, the ESP32-S3 should have had a huge performance advantage, but in practice, the Pico 2 handled the code more efficiently and finished significantly faster. This highlights something important. Clock speed alone doesn't tell how fast a board really is. The architecture of the processor, the instruction set, the memory latency, and even how well the compiler optimizes the code, all of that plays a role. And in this case, the Pico 2's Cortex M33 core with hardware FPU clearly handled the floating point heavy calculation much faster than the ESP32-S3's LX7 cores. To illustrate just how much architecture matters, let's switch to the RISC-V cores that the Pico 2 also offers, while keeping the frequency the same. Running the exact same benchmark on the RISC-V cores, performance dropped dramatically. The Pico 2 took 8.8 seconds to complete the task, more than twice as long as it did using its ARM Cortex M33 cores at the same clock speed, and significantly slower than the ESP32-S3. This doesn't mean the RISC-V cores are useless. They are lightweight and open, and they may be great for certain types of control logic or low-level tasks, but for number-crunching workloads like this one, they are clearly not the right tool, especially when the same board gives you the option to boot into Cortex M33 cores with full FPU support. To see what happens when both boards run at the same clock speed, I overclocked the Pico 2 to 240 MHz and ran the benchmark again. The Raspberry Pi Pico 2 completed the task in exactly 3 seconds, while the ESP32-S3, running at the same 240 MHz, still needed 4.7 seconds. That means the Pico 2 was about 36% faster, even though both boards were operating at identical clock speeds. When I ran the RISC-V cores on the Pico 2 at 240 MHz, the performance improved compared to their lower clocked run, but still fell far behind the other results. The task completed in 6.3 seconds, which is faster than at 150 MHz, but still more than twice as slow as the same board using its Cortex M33 cores, and over 30% slower than the ESP32-S3, even though all three were running at 240 MHz. This clearly demonstrates just how efficient the Cortex M33 architecture is, with its streamlined pipeline, modern instruction set, and mature toolchain support. It consistently outperforms both the ESP32-S3's LX7 cores and the Pico 2's RISC-V cores, even when all are running at the same clock speed. The RISC-V cores, while flexible and open in design, appear to struggle with this type of workload, likely due to a combination of architectural differences, instruction handling efficiency, and less mature compiler optimizations. I also pushed the Pico 2 further, overclocking it to 300 MHz. At that speed, it completed the same benchmark in just 2.8 seconds. That's incredibly fast and especially impressive when you consider how energy efficient the board is, as we are about to see next. Let's now compare the ESP32-S3's performance with that of the original ESP32. Both chips are based on the Extensa architecture, but they use different cores. The original ESP32 uses LX6 cores, while the ESP32-S3 upgrades to LX7 cores, which promise better performance and efficiency, at least on paper. In the same benchmark, the original ESP32 completed the task in 4.7 seconds, identical to the result we just saw from the ESP32-S3. So, despite the updated architecture, there is no measurable improvement in this test. That was a bit surprising. I expected the LX7 cores to show at least a modest gain in performance, but with this particular code, there is no advantage at all. This suggests that while the ESP32-S3 introduces some meaningful hardware improvements like vector instructions and better power efficiency, those benefits don't always translate into faster execution for standard single-core floating-point workloads like this one. Let's now take a look at power consumption. At 150 MHz, the Raspberry Pi Pico 2, together with the display, draws about 31 milliamps. When overclocked to 240 MHz, that rises to around 40 milliamps. In comparison, the ESP32-S3 running at the same 240 MHz and using the same display draws around 81 milliamps, more than double what the Pico 2 needs at the same frequency. When the Pico 2 is switched to its RISC-V cores, the current draw is slightly higher than with the ARM cores. At 150 MHz, it draws around 37 milliamps, and at 240 MHz, about 44 milliamps. So, despite being significantly slower in performance, the RISC-V cores actually use more power, making them less efficient in this particular workload. However, it is important to know that we can't directly compare the processor current draw alone, since the boards have different power circuitry and designs. Factors like voltage regulators, onboard LEDs, and passive components can affect overall current consumption. This number represents the total board plus display draw, not just the microcontroller. Also worth mentioning, during this test, Wi-Fi and Bluetooth were completely disabled on the ESP32S3 to keep the comparison fair. Even with those factors in mind, the takeaway is clear. The Cortex-M33 cores on the Pico 2 are not only faster, but also more efficient, completing the benchmark in less time while drawing significantly less current than the ESP32S3. That makes the Pico 2 a very compelling choice for low-power, high-performance embedded projects. Of course, the ESP32S3 brings other strengths to the table, like built-in Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and support for vector instructions. These features make it ideal for connected and AI-powered applications, where the standard Pico 2 simply can't compete. However, if you are looking for wireless capability without sacrificing performance, there's also the Pico 2W, which brings the same fast cores and efficiency, but adds Wi-Fi connectivity, making it a much closer alternative to the ESP32S3 for networked applications. And beyond raw compute power, the Pico 2 also offers DSP acceleration via the Cortex-M33 cores and supports programmable I/O, a standout feature that lets you implement custom protocols with precise timing and minimal CPU overhead. So there you have it. What do you think about these results? Did anything surprise you? Let me know in the comments. And if you found this comparison helpful, be sure to like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more deep dives into the world of embedded hardware.